everyone. Today is Monday and I've got the day off school today because it's a teacher training day. So yeah, I'm just going to be doing a vlog today and I've got the guinea pigs veggies, which is why they're going absolutely crazy. Now that the girls are in their new run, I scatter their food around and hide it in different places just to make them think about working for their food and just so it's not in a bowl straight in front of them. I thought it would be more interesting if it was all hidden in different areas and they could go and look for it. So I just like put it on top of the bendy bridges, on logs, on the tunnels and just places like that to make them work for it. Oh my god, Jasper. A few of you might be wondering what plants we have for the guinea pigs at the minute. So up there we have lemon balm, I think. And they can't really reach that one, but I know if it's low down they'll easily reach it and demolish the whole lot, so I've just hung it up, so it's kind of more for decoration and to make it look more natural than anything. Over there in that back corner we have lavender, and then next to that we have a pansy type flower, which they can actually reach surprisingly. You can see how tall that pot is, but they can just nibble around the edges of it, and that's safe for them to eat. All the plants are safe for them in here, and I've also got a few herbs just scattered around here because I couldn't think of a way to put them up high enough so they couldn't reach it, but like not too high, if you get what I mean. So we've put one here, and Pudsey hates basil, so I put it next to his run just on the shelf bit because I know he won't eat it. So that's just there. And then down here we have some rosemary, and the guinea pigs love this. They haven't eaten that much of it because it was quite high up when I had it in the run, so they couldn't really get to it. And then here is either mint or lemon balm. I don't know which one's which, but one of them. We just planted it in this adorable watering can, which I think is so cute. So that's all the plants we have. So I just made a smoothie and it's got banana, frozen raspberries, coconut milk and flaxseed in there. Basically all the guinea pigs have already had their breakfast and they're squeaking because they can smell my smoothie. Do you want some? No, you can't have any. I haven't actually shown you guys this yet, but I've changed Pudsey's shelf. It used to just be a 2x1, but now it's like an L shape. So before it was just like that. But then I made it go all the way around so he can watch Bramley if he wants to, or if he can watch the boys if he wants to. I haven't shown you guys this yet either, but the boys now have what I like to call a tree house. I think it looks like a tree house because it's kind of high up and there's a little bridge to get to it. I think it's so sweet. So this is what went onto their other outdoor pen. It used to like attach on and there was this bridge thing, but we got rid of the bridge because it was really slippy and it just wasn't really serving any purpose. And my mum attached this piece of wood all the way along there so it could hold the bridge and it wouldn't be dangerous. So she just put that there, and there's a little gap as you can see, and this is really strong, and the bridge just slots through there, and yeah, I just love it. I think it's really good. I put their hay in there so it's like a little bed area, and it doesn't really look that steep, but yeah, they managed to get up it fine, and I put a little log here just to help them get up. Are you going to demonstrate it? Are you going to demonstrate it? Oh, good boy. So it's not too difficult for them to get up, and they're really fussing now because Teddy keeps bonking Badger and Badger's not happy about it. So yeah, they're not having a very good day today, but I'm sure they'll be fine. So this is resting on this piece of wood that goes all the way across the run, and it just sits there nicely, and yeah, I'm really happy with it, and I think it just works really well.
Look at you, you little cutie. Would you be? Hello, sweetie pie. Hello, sweetie. Oh, they're lovely.
I wanted to let you guys know about what happened the other day. So I was just cleaning out all the guinea pigs, and then I got to the girls' room, and I was cleaning out theirs, and I looked in the hutch, and I found loads of blood, and it wasn't just in there. I started to clean this out too, and there was blood like all underneath the hay, and I was so worried, and it was even under the houses and everything. Hi, Rubes. Hello, baby. So we knew that one of them had been bleeding, which was really, really scary because it was a lot of blood, and we had no idea which guinea pig it was because we couldn't see it. We had to just look at them all, and even then we couldn't find out who it was. But we knew that Ruby had been ill because we thought she had a bladder infection a couple of weeks or months back, actually, and she was always squeaking when she was peeing, and we'd occasionally find a little bit of blood, and we thought it was from her, but we don't really know. So I just assumed that it was from Ruby because she was like, she had some bladder problems, and it was not like an injury where they caught themselves in something and started to bleed. It was definitely like blood in their pee. So we just assumed it was Ruby, and we took Ruby straight to the vets, and they checked her over, and the vet said that she was very sensitive in her bladder area, and the vet gave us some antibiotics and some powder stuff to go in the water bottles just to help the bladders, and we've had this before. It didn't help, but we had to try it again, just obviously to rule out anything, and it was a long course of it. But then we got home, we'd cleaned out all the blood and everything before we went to the vets, and then we came back with Ruby, and we looked in the run, and we found blood in the litter tray again, which was so scary, because then we realised that it wasn't actually Ruby, it was one of the other guinea pigs, because it had happened whilst we were out after we cleaned the litter tray. So we knew it wasn't Ruby, and then we had to check all the others. So I got Rolo because I knew Rolo wasn't very well. We think he's got cancer. We're not too sure, but we think he's got cancer. You can have an operation to try and get rid of the cancer, but it's obviously very risky, and I just don't think that's fair. We don't know fully if it's cancer, but that's the most likely thing. So he's happy now. He seems like he's fine. We picked him up and looked at him, and we saw blood on his private part, and it was just really scary. So we rung the vet, and they said to give the antibiotics to Rolo instead of Ruby.
Look at Jasper in his bed.
We've actually got a canopy, that's why he's sat under here. So he's sheltered from the rain, but he can still be outside. But you're a bit mad, aren't you, because it's really cold out here. Yes, you're a mad boy. But you're very, very cute in there. Oh, look at your little face. As you can see, we've now got this background for the Detolf, and it was bought off eBay. I think it was around £10 because, like, the more like length you get, the more expensive it is. So I had to get quite a lot of it, and it was around about £10. But I'm happy I bought it because I think it looks really great, and it just looks really nice. So I'm really happy with that. I added a few new things to their tank yesterday, and I thought I would just show you what I put in. So there we have a pumpkin, and it's hard to tell, but there's like a little gap in the bottom where they can get through. That's where you're supposed to put the tea light in. But that's a perfect little gerbil hole there, you can see. And they really like going in there and digging in that. And Chestnut has been a monkey. Oh God, he's trying to escape. scare me so much then. Don't you dare, little monkey, I'll put the lid back on. I have to take the lid off because it's reflecting through the glass, so I kind of have to do an overview thing. But he is being such a little bummer, so I'm just having to be very careful. I added in a mini plant pot there for them to dig in. Oh my god, you maniac thing. Yeah, this is why you need a lid on this tank, because they just jump out and they're very naughty, especially you. The others aren't so bad, but he's just a little monkey. So there is their mini plant pot. Now the camera's gone really fuzzy, but oh well. I think it's because of the soil actually, because it's so dark. It just makes everything else look really dark. Over there is a mushroom, oh my god. A mushroom toadstool thing, and it's meant for birds, but they can fit in. I think only one can fit in there, like at a time. But I thought that was adorable and I love it. So yeah, I'm just going to put the lid back on before Chestnut escapes. We actually had a gerbil escape once. The lid used to just sit on here instead of here on this bar. It used to sit right on here and there was like a gap. And then one morning I just woke up and saw Peanut on the floor and I was like, oh my goodness. But if my door had been open or it had happened when I was out or something, he could have like chewed everything in my bedroom, or if my door was open he could have escaped. So I was really lucky that it happened whilst I was in my bedroom. And yeah, I'm just going to put the lid back on now so he doesn't escape. Just look how cute Teddy is. He's been a very naughty boy, but he's so cute. You sure cute, mister? I've just been baking and I've made some chocolate cupcakes and some flapjack. I need to ice these. I've iced all the buns and this is what they look like. Today is weigh day for the guinea pigs and I'm just going to get them all. First we have Bramley and he is 1408. Next we have Pudsey and he is 1438. Ruby is 1198. Teddy is 1150. Rolo is 996. Next we have Millie, who weighs, she's not staying still. What are you? 979 grams. Here we have Oreo, and she's a bit of a fidget, so it's kind of hard to weigh her. But she is 1105 grams. Finally, Badger is 916 grams. I'm just about to clean the guinea pigs out, but I think I'm going to end the vlog here. So, yeah, I will see you guys soon. Bye.